tardes. La Universidad Castro Carazo les da la más cordial bienvenida a este espacio que hemos preparado para todas y todos ustedes. Mi nombre es Ivania Vega, coordinadora de Vida Estudiantil, y tendré el gusto de acompañarles el día de hoy. Les informamos que este evento está siendo grabado, por lo que les solicitamos mantener sus micrófonos silenciados y cámaras apagadas mientras no se encuentren participando. Para una mejor experiencia, en la parte superior derecha de la pantalla podrán activar la vista de galería y esto les permitirá ver a todas las personas participantes. Muy bien, contarles que el día de hoy, en colaboración con el Centro de Idiomas, tenemos esta charla para ustedes sobre técnicas y estrategias para entrevistas en inglés. Antes de iniciar y de contarles quién es la persona o las personas que nos van a acompañar, les quiero contar acerca de la dinámica de este espacio. Este taller se va a desarrollar en idioma inglés. Sin embargo, no queremos limitar la participación de ninguna persona. Entonces, si tienen alguna duda o consulta, la pueden hacer tanto en inglés como en español. Y nosotras pues, nos vamos a encargar de dar respuesta a la mayor cantidad de ellas. También hemos habilitado el espacio del chat precisamente para que nos puedan anotar ahí sus consultas o preguntas. Y también cuando la persona moderadora lo indique, si alguna persona desea participar de forma verbal, pueden en la parte de reacciones levantar la manita y con gusto les vamos a activar el micrófono. Muy bien, ahora sí, para iniciar, quisiera presentarles a Liana Rojas. Liana es la directora del Centro de Idiomas y ella nos va a acompañar en este espacio el día de hoy. Liana, bienvenida. Es un gusto compartir este espacio con vos.
Muchas gracias, Iva. Buenas tardes a todos y todas. Mi nombre es Liana Rojas, soy la directora del Centro de Idiomas. Les agradezco muchísimo por brindarnos este espacio a nuestros compañeros y compañeras de Bienestar Estudiantil y también a las personas docentes y estudiantes que nos acompañan de sede central, así como de otras sedes, porque también tengo entendido que contamos con un grupo de Occidente. Entonces, también un saludo a los docentes y las docentes de inglés que nos acompañan el día de hoy. Voy a compartirles pantalla porque vamos a empezar. Como Ivania se los dijo, la reunión, bueno, el taller de hoy va a ser una parte o la mayor parte en inglés, pero también podemos hacer comentarios en español, ¿verdad? Entonces, a partir de ahora, let's focus on our agenda. So first thing, as you said, the name is Acing Your Job Interview. Tips para tener éxito en una entrevista de trabajo en inglés. Okay? So the agenda is common questions and tricky questions. Okay? Common questions and tricky questions. And these are the objectives of this workshop. We are going to talk about some sample questions and answers, some tips. We are going to listen to your opinions, and we are going to talk about sample tricky questions and tips. Como hacia el final del taller, les vamos a compartir el link de este Genially, de este documento, para que ustedes puedan leer los artículos sobre cada una de las diferentes partes de el taller y así puedan prepararse mejor para la entrevista de trabajo, ¿de acuerdo? Entonces, el link de la presentación se las vamos a compartir hacia el final. Okidoki. So, we're going to start with the first point in our agenda. Common questions. What are some common questions that are asked during a job interview? Now, for this question, I would like for you to write in the chat common questions during job interview, during your job interviews that you've had in the past, or if you are a job interviewer, what are some questions that you usually ask? Let's have a couple of minutes. Demos un par de minutitos para que todos y todas vayan escribiendo preguntas en inglés que son comunes en las entrevistas que les han preguntado, okay? And also, I would like to have a volunteer open the microphone and share a common question that you remember. Recuerden, si desean participar con el audio, levanten la manita para que los compañeros le levanten el audio. Okay, any volunteers? What are some common questions that are asked during a job interview? Do we have any volunteers? Andrea, Iva?
No, de
De momento
momento
no.
no, Liana. Tenemos
Okay.
algunas
Sí, tenemos.
preguntas. Ah, muy
Ya
bien.
tenemos a María José. María
Okay.
José, voy a proceder a reactivarte el micrófono. Nada más le das
Thanks
a
a
OK.
todos, María José. Hello.
Hello, everyone. Good evening.
Good evening. So, María José, thanks a lot for participating. What are some common questions that are asked during a job interview?
Well, from my experiences, could be like, tell me about yourself, or do you have any experiences in this position, or tell me your skills, or I forget the word in English that is debilidades.
Your weaknesses.
Weakness.
Weaknesses.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Thank you.
Weaknesses. Uh-huh. Thank you very much. Uh-huh.
You're welcome.
And the opposite of weaknesses would be your strengths, which is
Strength.
similar to tell me about your strengths or tell me about your skills, right? Strengths.
Okay. Thank you.
Uh-huh.
It could
So,
be
Maria
both.
Jose. Uh-huh.
It could be both skills or strength.
Strengths also includes personal characteristics. Like if you are organized, that's a skill and that's a
Okay.
strength. Uh-huh. But if you understand people's feelings, that's more strength than a skill. Okay.
Okay, thank you so much.
Okay, you're welcome. You're welcome. What about the questions in the chat? André, ¿nos puedes leer algunas de las preguntas en el chat?
Sí, claro, con mucho gusto. Aunque tenemos también la mano de, bueno, teníamos la mano de otro compañero, pero la acaba de bajar ahorita.
Okay.
Pero algunas preguntas, for example, is, do you have experience with the type of work? Another one, talk me about your soft skills. Another one, a friend told me that one time they asked him, if you were a kitchen appliance, which one would you be and why? Very
Okay,
funny.
I think this one fits into the second category, the tricky questions, but that's fine.
Another one. Why do you think you are the best fit for this position? How do you see yourself in 5 years? When the same question here. Why do you want to quit the current job? How good are you at the position? And the last one, can you tell me your reason for applying for this job?
Okay, very good. Excellent, excellent. Now, some of these common questions could also be considered tricky questions, which are the second set of questions that we are going to talk about. Okay, for the common questions, let's deal with some of the common questions. How did you hear about this position? Now, this is a very common question, but what is not very common is that we use the opportunity that this question gives us to impress the interviewer. If they ask us, how did you hear about this position? We need to be very honest and say, well, out of the many job openings that I found, this opening called my attention because your institution has these advantages over other institutions. So if they throw us this question, we can use this question to impress the interviewer, right? One, by telling the interviewer how much we know about this company we are applying for. I mean, this position we are applying for and this company we would like to work for. So here I have this step. Be honest and positive. If you found it in a general search, what made you choose this opportunity? And show how much you know about the company. Okay? How did you hear about this position? Do we have anybody in the audience who would like to answer this question? How did you hear about this position? Taking into account what I just said about impressing the interviewer with the answer? Come on, let's have somebody. Vamos a ver si tenemos a alguien que desee contestar esta pregunta. How did you hear about this position? Do we have anybody?
Yes.
Ajá.
Marlon,
go ahead. Marlon.
Hello, Marlon. Welcome.
Hello, hello. Welcome, everybody.
Uh-huh. Oh, Marlon, yes. You're Marlon. Hi.
Yeah, yeah. Hi.
Welcome.
Welcome.
Long time no see, long time no read.
Yes, yes.
So, Marlon,
true.
If I were your interviewer and I asked you about this, Marlon, how did you hear about this position? What would you say in order to use the answer to impress me as your interviewer? Go ahead.
Okay, it can be something like, I have the knowledge about your company. I mean, I researched about your company in your website, and I can say for what I notice is that you are a great company. You offer lots of benefits to their employees. And also that you are a worldwide recognized company. I would like to take part in this.
Excellent, Marlon. Thank you very much. A pleasure hearing you as always. Okay?
We have another hand.
Ah, we have another hand. Okay,
yeah,
okay.
Frank.
Frank, hello.
Hello, how are you?
Good. Thanks for participating. So, Frank, if I were interviewing you and if I asked you, how did you hear about this position, what would you tell me?
Well, I would tell you that I'm currently an active student. So I heard from the same university about this new option. So I decided to take it and improve my my English skills and learn a little bit about how to make interviews.
Okay, very good. Thank you, Frank. So excellent, Marlon and Frank. Very good. Uh-huh. So remember, every question that we are asked, we need to make it play in our favor. For every question, we need to aim at telling them, yes, I'm ready. Yes, I'm prepared. Mm-hmm. Even this one that seems not to be very, very competitive. Now, why should we hire you? Why should we hire you? So sometimes we know or we fear the answer to this question because we think, oh, maybe I don't have enough experience for this job, or oh, maybe I'm too young for this position. Some people think like that, or maybe I'm too old for the position, or maybe my degree is in education and they are looking for a person who has a background in marketing. So when they ask this, why should we hire you? We need to put ourselves in their shoes and say, well, even though you might think I don't have enough experience for the job, let me tell you that you should hire me because of the tasks that I have completed in the last positions where I have worked. So instead of telling them because I am efficient, because I am hardworking, which also is very important, but first, if there is something that we fear that doesn't fit right into their profile, we should attack with that first bit and say, even though my degree, well, first of all, even though my degree is in education and not marketing, let me tell you that I have had extensive experience in marketing jobs before. Mm-hmm. Something like that. So can we have a volunteer to answer this question? Why should we hire you? Suppose that I'm looking for somebody with more than 4 years of experience in the job, and you don't have the 4 years of experience. So can we have a volunteer?
Yes, we have two volunteers. The first is Marce.
Okay, Marce, hello.
Hello, hello, professor. No, it's because I have a question. And maybe in the last question, I can use always past time. For example, bueno, voy a decirlo en español mejor. ¿Cómo yo puedo decir, digamos, si me hicieron una pregunta de que yo trabajé, entonces yo puedo decir en el trabajo, o sea, yo puedo decir, yo he trabajado, I have worked
or in my previous job.
I have worked. Mm-hmm. ¿Cuál es mejor?
Es que depende, si usted todavía está trabajando en ese lugar, I have been working at the university for, I don't know, in my case, 6 years. Pero si yo trabajé, entonces I worked.
Okay.
¿Verdad? Si usas presente perfecto, es que todavía lo estás haciendo. Si usas pasado, es que ya no.
Uh-huh. Está bien, muchas gracias.
Thank you very much. Great, great question. Okay. Let's see the other volunteer. Why should we hire you?
We have Jesús Rivero, the next.
Jesús, hello.
Hear me? Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, yes. Sure. How are you, Jesús? Oh, welcome.
I'm fine. I'm very good, thank you.
So, Jesús, okay. Why should we hire you?
Well, you should hire me because even though I don't have the experience for the position, I'm able to learn and I'm easygoing or a really easy person to learn any type of job. And also I would like to share a little experience that I have in the place that I'm working right now. I tried to apply for a position in logistics. Even though I have a little experience, I worked in logistics for a long time before. It was a different type of logistics. I used to be through the logistics by land. I don't know how to say it. Which not by sea, mm-hmm. And the place where I'm working right now, they do all the logistics by sea, mm-hmm. So it was a challenge. I was having this interview and I tell them, even though I don't have experience to anything by sea, I can learn, or find by myself everything that is related to, and I'm study also administration, so it goes ahead to the position.
Great. Jesus, and you're doing something very good. You're taking a weaknesses, sort of, and you are making it play for you. And you are making it be a strength. I don't have a lot of experience in land, like in sea logistics or in seabound logistics, but I can learn fast. And I can tell you that I learned very fast when I worked with land procedures or land logistics, okay?
Yes,
great, excellent.
Thanks.
Thank you very much. So we move to the next question. How do you handle pressure? This is also a common question. How do you handle pressure? And for this one, my tip is use the STAR method. What is the STAR method? Situation, task, action, and result. Situation, task, action, and result. Y por cierto, antes de que se me olvide, la universidad, dentro de estos talleres que estamos teniendo de empleabilidad, va a tener un taller sobre the STAR method. Y si yo fuera ustedes, buscaría información sobre ese método porque es buenísimo para las entrevistas. Entonces, ¿qué será el STAR method? Okay, if you ask me, how do you handle pressure? And I say, I try not to get angry, or I never get angry. That's not true. We all get angry. We all get under stress. So it's better to say, okay, For example, how do I handle pressure? For example, when I have to negotiate, let's say I have to negotiate with a certain group of people, what I do first is I send them a survey so that I know what their opinions are before I meet with them. And then I can take actions that result in agreement. Okay? Como ven aquí, yo ya no estoy diciendo, sí, me enojo, no me enojo, o me estreso, o no me estreso. Estoy diciendo, ¿qué hago cuando tengo una situación específica que genera estrés? Again, how do I handle stress? Well, how do I handle, what was it, pressure? Well, when I am in stressful situations and I have to negotiate with a group of people, I send them, so that's the situation. I send them a survey. That's the task. I send them a survey. I find out about their needs and their wants and their opinions. Then I take action, and those actions lead to a result. Okay? So does anybody want to give an answer to this question? How do you handle pressure using the STAR method? Come on. Let's have somebody.
We have one rising hand.
Okay,
from
okay.
Maria Jose.
Okay, Maria Jose.
Teacher, first of all, I have a question. It could be like a tricky question because it's so common that we are in interview. The real question is, tell me a story or a moment or an experience that you have had that you experienced a lot of stress. Could be the same.
Exactly, exactly.
Okay.
Actually, this question is the question that you're mentioning in disguise. Es esa misma pregunta disfrazada. How do you handle pressure? It's the same in disguise. And for the question that you just mentioned, the STAR method is also the answer. Give me the situation, give me the task, give me the action, and give me the result. So, Maria Jose, how do you handle pressure?
Okay, when I am into a very stressful situation, first of all, I see what I have. Mm-hmm. Also, what I need, what the activities that I have to do it. Mm-hmm. I also, when I confirm the activities that I have to do or that information that I need or the support that I need from another people, I do by myself. And after that, I see the result that I got for the task that I really did.
Mm-hmm. Now, you could narrow it down to a real life situation, right? And you could say, for example, or an example of this was a project I was working with 2 months ago. So that's the situation. And then, you know, you guide the people through a general overview of that situation and then saying that finally you got the results that you wanted because you finished the project on time with agreement from the majority of people who were part of the project. All right?
Yes, I was thinking in a specific situation, but for that reason I asked if it would be both because this is more like general. Like,
yeah, but if you answer a general question with a specific example, that's even better.
Okay.
So take general questions and answer them with the specific examples because that's what people want to see. Right? That's what people want to hear, how you deliver the results that they expect. Okay? So yes. Tell me about, can you tell us the situation in general terms without, you know, disclosing confidential information?
Well, when I started in my job, when I started, the accounting department was a little mess. Because mm-hmm. all the employees have quit recently and nobody continue with the process. I saw the situation. I start asking what I have to do it, which information I need, or asking people that why in the past people does.
People have and done.
Have uh-huh. done, yes, sorry. Uh-huh. And after that, I decided to create my own process with all the information that I got. I created mm-hmm. my own process, and thanks to this information, nowadays I can use this information for get numbers more real and more mm-hmm. or faster.
Uh-huh.
Real
Excellent.
And faster.
Excellent. What I would change or what I would adapt a bit, instead of saying they had a messy situation, you could say I faced a challenging situation.
Okay.
Because if you say messy, it sounds like you are judging them. And judging a previous employer is not a good thing in an interview. Although you're not saying the name of the employer, but it would be better to say I faced a challenging situation and this how I went about it. Okay?
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Maria Jose. Mm-hmm. Let's see. What questions do you have for me? That would be the next common question. So if you get asked this question, use the question. Be smart. Use the question to your benefit. You could ask about the company culture. You could ask the skills that this job needs. Mm-hmm. Or you could ask about a specific campaign or objective that this company has. If you ask about the company culture, they think, this person is really interested in this job. If you ask about what it takes to perform well in the job, they say, this person really is focused on having the skills that they need for the job. Or if you ask about a specific campaign, they're going to say, this person did research on the job. Okay, so for these ones, I'm not going to ask you because we are going to jump straight ahead. Okay, this is a summary of the common questions that we discussed. Remember that I'm going to give you the link to this presentation, so you will have time, you will have the opportunity to check every single article that I researched that is here, right? We're going to jump into the tricky questions. And for that, I'm going to ask my peers, les voy a pedir a mis compañeros y compañeras de Bienestar Estudiantil que les pongan el link a un Padlet donde ustedes nos van a decir cuáles son esas tricky questions que han escuchado que les hacen, pero las bien tricky, ¿verdad? A ustedes les han hecho en una entrevista o que ustedes han escuchado. Por ejemplo, la del kitchen appliance. That is a tricky question, okay? So for that, I'm going to give you like 3 minutes. And the way in which we can do this is we click and we add a title. And we ask, we don't ask. And we write here the situation, okay? And then we publish, right? Mm-hmm. Again, what you do is you click here in the plus sign or in this sphere. Click here, write a title or your name because we want to know who you are and sometimes this is anonymous. And write the tricky question or the hardest question that you were asked. Mm-hmm. So let's see, a couple of minutes to see your participations. Go ahead. Ajá, ya veo que algunas personas están escribiendo muy bien. Esa del kitchen appliance me parece genial para ponerla aquí. André, can you please tell me the one of the kitchen appliance? ¿Cómo era?
Yes, I have the question.
Is it like this one that I just wrote?
Let me check.
If you could be a kitchen appliance, which one would you be and why?
Yes, the same
okay.
question.
Okay, so Marlon says, tell me about a time when you needed to persuade someone to do something for you. If you could be remembered for one phrase, what would it be? Oh my goodness, that's very hard. What did you dislike about your previous job? What is the weakness related to this job position? Tell me about a time when you failed at something. What did you learn from that experience? Let's give a couple more minutes. Laura says, when I applied to my current job, they asked me, tell us what was the most challenging situation and to need to take action to achieve your personal objectives. Explain with a real example. None. You've never been asked a hard question. Good for you, none. What's something you do not like about your old job? How much do you expect to get paid? All right. Now, could you please vote? Look at these questions and vote with your thumbs up for the hardest question that you see here in the Padlet. Let's see. Just go to the Padlet and let's look at the thumbs up. Let's give thumbs up to the question that you think is the hardest from all the ones that they shared. One, two, we have a tie. One here, one here, two here. So let's see. I think this one would be extremely hard for me. That's me. Four, what did you dislike about your previous job? Three, the one of the weakness. Three, how much do you expect to get paid? Four, five. My greatest weakness is that I can be overly critical of my own work. This is a great, Andre, this is a great answer to what's your biggest weakness. This is a great answer. Great. So according to the participants in this workshop, the two hardest questions from the ones shared in the Padlet were, what did you dislike about your previous job and how much do you expect to get paid? Okay, let's see if we have one or two of these ones here in the part about tricky questions. So here I have some tricky questions that I found that are very, not popular at all. Why did you leave your last job? Why have you changed jobs so often? What are your salary expectations? And what's your biggest weakness? So we have Andre's answer could be a great answer to this one. So for what are your salary expectations? I found this sample answer that we could, you know, either practice, either internalize it, adapt to ourselves. So I'm looking for more than just the salary. I'm looking for the salary, the benefits, the company culture, the experience, the personal growth. And a way to give it back to them would be, I would love to know, what have you budgeted for this role? Okay, so les devolvemos la pregunta. If they ask us about the salary expectations, what have you budgeted for this role? Yeah, there's nothing wrong with asking them about the salary. Nothing, nothing wrong. So first we can say, yes, I'm interested in the job, but I'm interested in more than the salary. I'm interested in the benefits that the company offers, in the culture the company has, in the personal growth I can get. But well, sure, tell me about the budget for this position. What's the budget? What's the salary? After they tell us about that, we can think about the market, because we have done research about the average salary, right? And that gives us a point of comparison. Why did you leave your last job? This is very similar. This is very similar to what did you dislike about your previous job? And I found a great answer that is short and concise. It just wasn't my professional fit. Like that? It just wasn't my professional fit. If the interviewer asks you, why not? Well, because my personal and professional growth was what I expected. Period. Period. Or because the company values were not the same as my personal values. You could say that as well. But it just wasn't my professional fit. Short, concise, very honest, and very, very brief, honest, professional. We are not criticizing the company. We are focusing this question on us. Wasn't my professional fit. Okay? Ni nos estamos echando la culpa a nosotros, ni le estamos echando la culpa a la compañía. Y estamos siendo muy honestos. Okay? I love this phrase. Wasn't my professional fit. Why? Because it didn't allow me to grow personally or professionally as much as I expected to. Mm-hmm. Why have you changed jobs so often? Some people ask that. A good answer could be, right now, I'm in the process of looking for a long-term professional home. Professional home. Nice concept. I absolutely see this role as a long-term investment on my end. As a long-term investment, which is true. We all are looking for a long-term professional home. Maybe it's not this company, but we are not going to tell them that. It's just, I'm looking for a long-term professional home. That's what I want. And I see this role as a long-term investment. That means I want to stay here for some time, a long-term investment. Okay? What's your biggest weakness? Okay, going back to Andre's answer. Andre, are you there? Can you read your answer? Can you turn on the volume and read your answer?
Andre, please raise your hand to habilitate the micro.
Hi, Andres. Andre, are you there? No? All right, then I'll read it. He says, my greatest weakness is that I can be overly critical of my own work. I have high standards for myself, which sometimes leads me to spend too much time perfecting details. However, I've been actively working on this by setting more realistic deadlines and reminding myself that progress is more important than perfection. This approach has helped me improve my productivity while maintaining quality. Mm-hmm. Esta es una excelente respuesta, pero es excelente no solo porque está diciendo el weakness, es excelente porque está diciendo cómo está atacando esa debilidad. Setting more realistic deadlines. and reminding myself that progress is more important than perfection. Okay, entonces, si nos hacen esta pregunta, what's your biggest weakness? La clave no es tanto decir cuál es la debilidad, sino decir qué es lo que estoy haciendo yo para atacar esa debilidad de una vez, ¿verdad? De una vez. Por ejemplo, I used to try to do it all at once. Todo lo quería hacer al mismo tiempo. But now I have a deadline of my own before the actual deadline. So I have enough time. Simple, honest, concise, brief, professional. Okay? Entonces, what's your biggest weakness? La digo, pero también digo cómo la he estado atacando. Y al estar diciendo cómo la he estado atacando, ¿qué demuestro? Que soy una persona organizada, honesta, profesional. Ajá. Y entonces, una pregunta que podría ser muy general, la estoy aterrizando en algo más específico. Y veo que casi todo es aterrizarlo a más específico, excepto preguntas como esta. ¿Qué no le gustaba del trabajo? ¿Por qué se fue del trabajo? Lo aterrizamos en algo más general. It just wasn't my professional fit. Period. Uh-huh. Entonces, si la pregunta requiere una respuesta que nos va a poner como en problemas, la respuesta es mejor que sea general y corta. Y si la pregunta es muy general, la aterrizamos para que sea específica y nos permita impresionar. All right? Mm-hmm. So these are the tips for the tricky questions. And thanks and best of luck. Am I ready for this interview? False. The question is this interview ready for me? All right? Entonces, quisiera agradecerles y si tenemos espacio para preguntas, go ahead. Frank has a question.
Well, my question would be, to tell the person, if I tell you to quit your actually job, would you do it right away?
Ah, wow, 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 wow. Wow. That is a sword of two edges, una espada de dos filos. Because if you say yes, they are going to say, what if this person did that to me? So you would say, the answer would be, well, I need some time to give some, I need to give some time to my other company and try to set everything ready before I leave them because I am very professional and I wouldn't like to leave them like that, you know? Y por dentro tal vez usted diga, and maybe deep inside you are saying, oh, no, 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 no. But let me tell you, this is a double sword, a double-edged sword. Uh-huh.
That's right.
Can we have, Frank, excellent question. Excellent, excellent question.
Thank
Jesus.
You.
Yeah, Jesus. Jesus?
Hello?
And before,
can you hear me?
Hi. Yes, hi. Jesus. And before we listen to Jesus, Frank, let me tell you something. I was a recruitment, I was head of recruitment in a company. For 2 years, I did, I don't know, like 200, 300 interviews per year. And if somebody had told me, or if I had told somebody, I need you now, I wouldn't have hired. Personally, I wouldn't have hired the person. If the person said, oh, yes, yes, I'm going to leave them right away. See what they can do. I wouldn't have hired the person. Okay? So, Jesus.
Yes, it's more like knowing a little bit more about the START method. About the START method.
The START method.
I was thinking about working on assembly line,
So if we have situation, what we do about situations is first we made a meeting. We group as a team. Yes. You listen to me?
No, can you please say that again? I lost you for a while.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, sure. Yeah. Go ahead.
I work in an assembly line, so I want to learn a little bit more about the STAR method because I'm in a leadership program. And they told us when we had a situation, first, we have to make a group, like a meeting. Talk about the situation. It's like a survey. What is your opinion? Let all the people speak their mind.
Then
we got the main idea of the situation, the problem. And we make actions about it. Like if we talk too much or we're doing something wrong, not doing it again. That's where I try to relate the start method of a interview to real life. So
great. Excellent. Thanks for sharing, Jesus. And also remember, we are going to have a workshop about the STAR method on July 20th. July 20th, STAR method workshop. And I think you can ask our peers from Bienestar Estudiantil about that workshop. It's in Spanish, but it's about the STAR method. Great. Nazaret. Yeah. Hello, Nazaret. Go ahead.
Good evening, my teacher. My question is, the hope they face more technical job interview.
I'm sorry? Can you say that again?
My question is, how to face more technical job interview?
How to face a more technical job interview? That's a great question. There are many pages online, Nazaret, where you can ask. Especially, there is a site called Glassdoor. This Glassdoor site, gives you information about people who have worked in very large transnationals. And so you have lots of opinions there. And you could go to Glassdoor and ask for advice about technical job interviews, okay? Especially because in that site, you could find people who have worked, as I said, for large transnationals around the world. And my advice would be look online. There's lots of questions for specific companies online. You could just Google, I don't know, logistics interview for Crowley and find some hints. Okay? Does that help? Nazaret? Mm-hmm. Glassdoor, I consider that. So Nazaret, does that help answer your question? Okay, I think you're muted, Nazaret. Okay, we have Rosa and we have Laura. So Rosa, tell us.
Hi.
Yeah, tell us, Rosa. Oh, okay. Andre, could you please help Nazaret with the sound, with the audio? Andre?
Oh, thanks, teacher.
Yeah. So, Nazaret, Glassdoor. Go to that site. I'm sure it's going to help you a lot. Glassdoor.
Mm-hmm. Thank you very much, teacher.
You're welcome. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye. So, Laura, go ahead.
Hello, good afternoon. First of all, I really appreciate all this information because actually I'm in the process to move on to a new job opportunity outside Costa Rica, as a nurse. I'm a registered nurse already. So, but I'm out of shape in this field because in my current job, I still for 15 years. Can you imagine this? So how can I don't know, develop my skills to face this very important information interview with a nursing director in some hospital? So where I can read some information, and I had the question that it's necessary to speak a little bit more about my skills as a nurse or my knowledge, because I'm so worried about how, what kind of details I need to explain in that opportunity.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Great. I would say in order to start getting like information about the profile, visit some large hospitals.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see, because I hear some sound. Is it you? That's okay.
Yes, maybe. Excuse me.
No, that's no problem. Look for some hospitals and look for the careers part of the page where they have careers. Go to the careers section and you will see that they have the description of each position. That is going to help you a lot, vocabulary wise and preparation wise. So look for careers. Careers and identify the position. And once you have identified the position, there you have the vocabulary. And so you can practice. Also, look for Google and look for mock job interviews for nursing jobs. Or ChatGPT. Ask this question to ChatGPT. Give me mock interview jobs, interview questions for nursing jobs.
Yes, because it's the first time.
ChatGPT is going to throw you that.
Yeah, that's the first time that I face this experience. So I'm so excited, but I'm so worried about it because I need to do very well at the first time.
Okay.
Yeah, this is very important. It depends on the recruiter resources. And actually, I'm looking for a new opportunity, maybe on Missouri. So I had, 15 years without working in a hospital, and they are worried about this. So I need to convince them that I had experience, I had the knowledge, and I had the skills, that I don't lose it for the pass of the time. So it's so challenging to me.
A good thing you could do, even if you don't have the experience, from right now, go and register a nursing course to refresh your skills.
Do it
right away.
I'm in the process. To find, opportunity to take again a new classes, because everything has changed. Yes, everything has changed.
Do it right again.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and it's necessary. I must to do, but I'm still working in that.
Okay. So use ChatGPT to ask them about mock interview questions for nursing positions. Okay?
That's a very good advice, and thank you very much.
You're very welcome. Bueno, jóvenes, pienso que ya, creo que ya estamos con el tiempo. Entonces, aquí nos están invitando a dejar la realimentación del taller. También creo que Ivania, bueno, agradecerles antes de que Ivania les cuente una sorpresita que les tenemos, agradecerles por su presencia, especialmente los grupos de inglés que nos acompañaron hoy, de los compañeros Ana Laura, Daniel y Manuel, que tenemos grupos aquí en Sede Central y también en Sede Occidente. Muchísimas gracias por habernos acompañado. A todas las personas en general, muchísimas gracias por habernos acompañado. Les voy a dejar aquí mi correo porque tal vez si tienen alguna consulta, alguna duda, si desean conocer sobre nuestros programas de inglés, ¿verdad? Entonces, con todo gusto pueden escribirme. Entonces, Ivania, muchísimas gracias. Disfruté mucho interactuar con este grupo tan bonito. Muchísimas gracias por la oportunidad.
Muchísimas gracias, Liana, y muchísimas gracias a todas las personas que también estuvieron participando. Eso nos alegra mucho. Bueno, esa es la idea, que aprovechen este espacio. Esperamos que les sean de mucha utilidad todas estas técnicas y estrategias que nos compartió Liana. En el chat les estamos dejando el enlace para ver la presentación, porque tiene... tiene ahí algunos comentarios en burbujas con información que les dejó Liliana importante para que tengan a mano. Y bueno, también les estamos compartiendo en el chat del evento el enlace de evaluación de este evento para que ustedes nos puedan dejar sus opiniones y comentarios. Y bueno, esto nos va a ayudar a mejorar próximas actividades. También contarles que, bueno, les tenemos una sorpresita, y es que queremos obsequiar entre todas las personas que nos acompañaron el día de hoy una revisión completa del CV en inglés y una hora de práctica individual para entrevistas con Liana. Liana nos va a apoyar con este obsequio y, bueno, entonces les motivo a participar de este obsequio. ¿Cómo lo pueden hacer? Es muy sencillo. Solamente tienen que ingresar al enlace que les estamos dejando en el chat de la evaluación. Nos dejan ahí sus datos personales y próximamente les vamos a estar informando quién va a ser la persona favorecida con este maravilloso obsequio, y que además es personalizado. Así que no se lo pierdan, por favor. Muy bien, contarles que la próxima semana vamos a tener una actividad que se llama Etiqueta Digital, fortalecer tus habilidades de comunicación escrita en el ámbito profesional. Entonces, esta actividad es muy importante para mejorar nuestras habilidades laborales y les invitamos cordialmente a acompañarnos. Si no se han inscrito, lo pueden hacer. También les estamos dejando el enlace para que se puedan inscribir en esta charla. Y bueno, este mes tenemos... cargado de actividades. Aquí, como puedan ver, está la actividad que les comentó Liana, que son plataformas de empleo en tendencia y métodos STAR. Esta es una actividad presencial con cupo limitado. Se realiza en San José, en el edificio ITEA. Entonces, si gustan participar, igual se pueden inscribir en este evento. Y bueno, en cualquiera de los eventos que tenemos durante este mes, pueden participar. Son espacios en su mayoría virtuales, son gratuitos y abiertos a cualquier público. Es decir, si ustedes conocen un amigo o amiga que quisieran recomendarle alguna de estas actividades, lo pueden hacer. No es necesario que sea estudiante de la U para que pueda participar. Todas y todas las personas son bienvenidas a nuestras actividades. Y bueno, también parte de algunas actividades gratuitas o servicios que brindamos, también forman parte del Centro Inglés. Entonces, quisiera que Liana nos contara un poquitito. Ya nos contó de los programas que tiene la Universidad en Inglés, pero que también nos cuente de otro servicio que tiene la U muy importante.
Ok, muchas gracias. Nosotros tenemos Club de Conversación para aquellas personas que tengan un nivel A2 en adelante. Entonces, para participar en el club de conversación, que es gratuito, pueden escribir a mi correo. Lo que vamos a hacer es que se les realiza un diagnóstico de nivel. Ya una vez realizado el diagnóstico, les damos las fechas en que se realiza y les damos el link para que ingresen. También tenemos el programa English Plus, que es un programa conversacional que va desde nivel A1 básico, ¿verdad?, hasta un nivel intermedio alto. Y también tenemos un nuevo programa que se llama Inglés para Tecnología y Negocios, que es un programa para personas que tengan un B1 en adelante, utilizando la plataforma de Cisco Skills for All. Esa es una novedad que tenemos. Entonces, ¿desean más información sobre alguno de estos tres programas? Con todo gusto, al correo, aquí se los estoy volviendo a poner. Vamos a ver. Muchas gracias, Iva.
Excelente, muchas gracias, Liana. Y bueno, también contarles que constantemente estamos realizando actividades en la universidad y Queremos invitarles entonces a que nos puedan seguir en nuestras redes sociales para que no se los pierdan. Nos pueden seguir en el Facebook de la Universidad Castro Carazo y en el Instagram. También tenemos el Facebook de Bienestar Estudiantil de la Universidad Castro Carazo, donde van a poder ver publicadas todas las actividades que se desarrollan mes a mes y los enlaces para poder inscribirse. Y para las personas estudiantes, recordarles que también tenemos el boletín La U Siempre Cerca, que llega cada viernes puntualmente y tiene un montón de información, no solo de las actividades, sino de todos los procesos que se llevan a cabo en la universidad y que es información muy importante para ustedes en su transitar por la universidad. Entonces, les invitamos a estar atentos a estas redes y a estar comunicados a través de ellas. Y muy bien, finalmente agradecer a todas las personas por su compañía y puntualidad. Esperamos que nos puedan acompañar en próximos espacios. Que tengan muy bonita noche. Hasta luego.
Buenas noches.